Well, YouTube, this is Shadow King KingNazaru's, and guess what? As of about 13 hours ago, I just turned 24. So yeah, today is my birthday. Anybody wants to congratulate me for making it 24 years on this earth? Feel free to do so in the comment section. Really excited about it. So, what's best to do to celebrate this? Oh, I know. How about we do a very special Rosario Vampire 2 chapter? We'll start off with chapter 31. Mocha is running back home to get her rosary while wondering why her mother is saying this is farewell, because she really doesn't want to leave her mother. And this is so unlike her to separate from her. Back at the castle, Akua realizes that Akasha sent Mocha away because of how dangerous Akua is. And Akua admits she was jealous of the two and wanted a deep bond with Mocha. Akasha mentions how when Mocha was born, she was weak and dying. And this made her so distraught that Akasha started praying to God. It's really surprising to see a vampire pray to God. But trust me, this is going to be really important in the end. Akua says she cares about Mocha too, and is glad Akasha sent her away, as her feelings held her back for over a year. So she was planning on trying to kill Akasha and take her blood for about over a year now, and it was Mocha that was holding her back. And to further confirm this, Akua says that she wants Akasha's blood since she's one of the three Dark Lords, in fact the leader in fact, and was one of the three people that defeated Dracula. And Skuna and Misery are shocked that Mocha's mom is a Dark Lord, and Toa Fuhai says that he didn't tell them because, well, he didn't tell them, but he wasn't exactly hiding it either, because he and the others never referred to themselves as the Dark Lords. That was just something that other people called them. And he also said that Akasha, when she was a Dark Lord still fighting, she has unrivaled strength, but her one weakness was that she was too nice. She's got Superman syndrome. And that it's going to hinder her in fighting her own stepdaughter. Toha also says that Akua has the edge of the killer intent, but also a secret technique she has. And Akua tries to do a dimension stab with Akasha barely being able to dodge it. And Akua says the move uses barrier arts to delay her existence and let her pass and destroy physical objects. And the biggest reveal of this is, this was Toha Fuhai's original technique, called the Hogetsu Jigentao, or translated into Moon Crushing Dimension Sword. But we'll just call it the Jigentao. Akasha is shocked that Akua could learn the Jigentao, a Dark Lord's move, at such a young age. And Akua said that she lived with the Miyu family, who is in present time currently attacking the Wong family, where they're harboring the newspaper club. And during the years, Akua became their assassin and eventually learned the Jigentao, all for the sole purpose of defeating Akasha so she can drink her blood and become a Shinzo vampire. Akua then starts to swipe at Akasha's chest and causes a deep cut. And she continues to get the upper hand by using her speed, agility, and different dimension techniques. Akua then demands her stepmom to stop holding back because There's no way a Dark Lord could be this pathetic in a fight, even with one of them using a Dark Lord's technique as well. And Akasha confirms that she's holding back, but she also knows that Aqua is holding back too. And she quickly heals. Then Mocha arrives and sees that Aqua is fighting their own mother. And Aqua relents that Mocha has to be there to see this and how this might have an effect on her, but she still plans on killing Akasha. And she then uses the Jigen Tao to cut Akasha in half. That is some heavy shit for somebody to see at a young age. I mean, this is practically Walking Dead stuff you would see. Aqua then apologizes to Mocha for seeing this, and she also confesses, shockingly enough, that she is a descendant of Dracula. This enrages Mocha and causes her to do her traditional hard kick to the face, sending Aqua flying across the hall. Aqua shockingly learns that Akasha, when she was talking about Mocha being close to death as a baby, that she must have given her blood, and thus Mocha is a Shinzo vampire. And the chapter ends off with the earthquake happening at the castle, and that Dracula's dormant body sends Mocha's power and is reawakening. Oh man, this was a really good chapter that's due on my birthday. And it had a dark tone. We got to see just how dangerous and determined Aqua is to get her goals, despite her conflicted feelings. And we just got to see just how powerful Mocha is. She is in the same class as her mother and Dracula. So we're going to be seeing the conclusion to this flashback soon. So, but trust me, it gets heavier from here on out. So I'll check it out next time in Chapter 32.